Changing the world, one act of kindness at a time. When you guys saw this and got the invitations, I'm wondering how many of you thought, you know, are they crazy? Idealists for sure. What's that all about? But we actually believe this 100% with our heart that it can be done. It can be done for a quarter or less. And we're here to inspire you to pay it forward in personal and business and to empower you to inspire others to do the same. And it is a ripple effect that is taking over the world. Certainly our industry has jumped on board like I can't even describe, and it's an incredible movement. So before we get too much into it, I wanted to show you a clip from my favorite movie in the world, and one that's going to kind of give you the feel of where we're going. Where's the sound? Stop. Whoa. Sorry, guys. Do you have to come and see if they can plug this in? Yeah, well, that's good. That's unfortunate. Oh, wow. Oh, the good, a tech guy. Sorry, guys. Thank you.
This is your assignment. Extra credit. It goes on all year long. Now, wait a minute. What? What's wrong with this? What's the matter? Yes?
It's like so...
So what? There must be a word to finish that sentence. Someone help her?
Weird.
Crazy.
Weird.
Crazy.
Hard.
Bummer.
Bummer. Hard. How about possible? It's possible. The realm of possibility exists where? In each of you. Here. So you can do it.
That's me. And that's three people. And I'm going to help them. But it has to be something really big. Something they can't do by themselves. So I do it for them. Then they do it for three other people. That's nine. And I do three more.
That's 27, so I'm not really good at math, but it gets big really fast, you know?
Articulation, please.
Yes.
I think it's a good idea.
Sean?
It's stupid.
Adam?
It's the honor system.
People blow off the honor system.
So what? Just because you do.
Well, Trevor, the class seems to think that you've come up with an overly utopian idea. Look that word up in a minute.
Like, a perfect world?
Mm-hmm.
So?
That's what Pay It Forward's all about. It's a remarkably simple concept, yet incredibly profound and compelling. The bracelet is an important aspect of it, not completely necessary, and we're going to explain all that as we go through, but it's all about passing on the kindness and asking that kindness to move forward. So with Pay It Forward bracelet, you wear the bracelet. The whole idea of the bracelet is to get rid of it, to pass it on to someone else when you've done something nice for them, and it could be as small as opening a door and smiling at them, up to donating millions and everything in between, giving them the bracelet and simply asking them to pay it forward. And then when they do the act of kindness, they pass it on, and the ripple effect goes around the world. And as it said at the beginning, we are already, with no advertising, no marketing, no virtually nothing at this point, 1.7 million bracelets in 124 countries. So it is kind of catching on. Thank you. So when we talk about Pay It Forward, people often will say, but if I get involved in Pay It Forward, what about these guys? What about my charity? What about, you know, my son's diabetic, my mom has cancer? You have all these issues. You say, well, what's going to happen with them? That's the beauty of Pay It Forward, because Pay It Forward is not a charity. It is the foundation upon which all charitable behavior is built. So we begin by spreading the word of kindness, getting people around the world to start thinking more kindly, to start being more giving, to start looking around us for someone in need, someone who needs help. And all of these people, all of these charities, all of the research will drastically benefit by a kinder society. Of course it will. It can't not. So as we all get injected with a feeling of, I want to look around outside of myself and see who I can help, all of this will come to fruition. The research will get done and may get done faster. The charities will thrive, and we will all be better people for it in helping them and helping ourselves. And that's a big part of this, too, is what, you know, where this comes from ourselves personally in business and where we are in the giving. And they actually do mesh beautifully. This also, though, explains to me why on a recipient level, and it's a quick story that we had, a friend of mine who said, I want to do this bracelet giving and I want us all to do this, but it has to be for needy people. You want to go out and find the homeless and find the hungry. And I said, that's awesome, because if that's what you want to do with it, that's great. That's what people always assume. But you have to know, too, that when I gave the bracelet, and I have done this, in a McDonald's line, I don't eat there, I just have coffee, to the guy behind me, and he's in a sports car with a sunroof, and he's not needy, I may have changed his day. And it, just by him saying, wow, that lady bought me a coffee and a muffin, wow, how great is that? And he may go to the office and give $50,000 to a charitable organization that walks into his office because he can. So the recipient is not designated in my mind. I don't believe we have specific recipients. I think kindness is overall general for all people at all times, in the office, at home. If you have kinder people, if you're happier people, you're happier at home, your kids are happier, that's a whole other ripple effect separate from the bracelet passing. So, I mean, obviously you can tell that I'm slightly passionate about it, and because I have seen it in effect in my life, in my business, in my community, in my world, in the schools and the kids, it's incredible. So just let me talk a little bit about the ripple effect. How this starts from here, Ed told you the basic story, and that's, we're going to keep it at that, because I met Charlie online through LinkedIn, online dating. Look at Charlie, look at me, you know that's not what happened. I met Charlie online. He actually posted the words pay it forward on LinkedIn, and I saw it after 10 years later after watching the movie. And I was so enlightened by that, thinking, who's doing that? Like, who's talking about that? It was my favorite movie. I love the concept. So I called Charlie. We brought it into CYA. My sister and I really took it to heart. We took it to the PPPC. Now they are launching officially this year, taking it to the members, and us, our membership will start that process to get to the 7 billion people around the world. And there are some people in our industry, you need to know, who have stepped up in amazing ways. You can see the support of Brand Alliance, in case you're wondering. That's, you know, they sponsored our session. We're wearing their outfits. You can seek these guys out, by the way, because they're very involved in it, and they are happy to talk with all of you if you have questions and what you want to do and what they want to share. They want to pay it forward. So please do that. But Brand Alliance has done it corporately. They also stepped up as a corporate sponsor for C2BK, which is the school program, as did Leeds, Redwood Classics, Debco. VP Marketing is here. Alain in the back is the official supplier for the C2BK bracelets. Debco is the official supplier for the Pay It Forward bracelets. We have people who are just coming in to our world and saying, I'm in. And it's unbelievable. We also have another special guest here I want to point out. His name is Farley Flex. Farley, can you just stand or wave or something? Just. We posted long ago on our Facebook, does anyone know Ellen or the Biebs, is how we put it. We feel those are the two icons that we want, Ellen for the adults and, you know, Justin for the kids. I like Justin, too. And in that, we got a connection to Farley. Farley, I'm going to read you his bio because I couldn't remember it. And he's in the entertainment business. He was the Canadian Idol judge for 6 years, but he's also the most philanthropic human being I have ever met. My sister and I were lucky enough to have a 3-hour dinner with him on Monday night, and I almost can't even tell you that without, you know. Anyway, he is the manager of Canada's first successful rapper, Maestro Fresh West, music director and VP of business development in Canada's first urban radio station, Flow 93. perennial judge on Canada's number one television show ever, Canadian Idol, national UNICEF ambassador, member of the Special Advisory Council to the League of Human Rights, director of Merry-Go-Round Kids, Cops, and Computers, director of Helping Hands International, founder of The Real School, which is reality education and applied life skills, and the CEO of Plasma Management and Productions. So that, and this man has come and said, I'm in. So Farley is here with us today to learn with the rest of you. So this is my favorite part. It's the power of one. What can I, just one person, do? And I've had that question asked of me many times since I started this. And the answer is, just do it. Step up, make the change, start being nice, and it will fall into place. Not everybody's going to devote themselves to the same level as everybody. Doesn't make a difference. If you just go out on the show floor today and you smile at one more person than you were going to before you got here, I'm good with that. Here's some is that's echoing, right? Sorry. Here's some quick stories. The Toronto landlord, I don't know if you read that in the Star this over Christmas, told everybody in his building to keep $70 back from their monthly rent so they could buy better gifts and nicer gifts for their families. That one's lovely. Winnipeg Tim Hortons, that was big in the paper. 224 people consecutively paid it forward for the people behind them, buying coffee all day long. It lasted hours and hours. It was amazing. And all this has gotten coverage. Panera Cares, Panera Bread is doing an amazing program where they have, in their fifth store that I think just came to my sister's city in Boston, where you pay what you can when you go into Panera Bread. And they've done this, and people will donate more, obviously, and give more so the people behind them can. Read it, go there, eat there, amazing place. Kmart layaway, beautiful story. A woman whose husband died went in, and she walked into her big Kmart and said, what is the price of everybody's layaway? At $50,000, and she handed it to them and said, call all those people and tell them to come and pick up their Christmas. So people are doing these kinds of things every single day. For us, our pay it forward, our process, it's cool to be kind because, and it's very topical. Sadly, it's topical because of the Amanda Todd story. But for me personally, bullying is the biggest unnecessary evil in the world. It's not necessary. No one needs to say something unkind to anyone else. It's cool to be kind is a program for school-age kids from preschool to university that is going to, I believe this, replace bullying with intentional kindness. So this program is part of Pay It Forward. It's the children's version. It's what my sister and I created, developed, and have grown and gotten sponsors for. Our association has stepped up, and we are now at starting our 16th school. We have had 50,000 bracelets donated, and the schools in your community in a very short period of time are going to be a lot nicer. So that's our take on it. You guys, again, everybody's going to do it their own way. We expect nothing from no one. You just need to take it in, decide what you want to do, how you want to do it, and then do it. So the ripple effect around the world, same thing. 1.7 million bracelets, 200,000 bracelets so far have been brought in by association members. And we haven't really launched it here yet. So people are stepping up. Those bracelets are out in the hands of others. They have traveled the world. They are in our communities and our schools. And I just want to say thank you. It is changing the world. We are, and we as a association with our 1,300 member companies and the however many member people, we could make the largest dent as a group ever. So the fact that you guys are here and we have 80 people sitting here ready to take it out there, it's just the very beginning, and we are very grateful that you decided to come with us on this. And what's in it for us? This is a question that obviously comes up to me a lot. People are saying, you're doing this, you're spending a lot of time, are you getting paid? I am getting paid. That's what I'm getting paid with. And that's what I want you guys to leave knowing, that giving and paying it forward is the most joyful experience in the world. And so is that selfish? I think it is. I think it is, because I feel good every single day because of someone else's reaction, because it's all about that. And I have to say, it's the pure, unadulterated kind of joy, the kind when you see your baby for the first time after giving birth, or the day you said I do on your wedding. It's that in the soul kind of joy. So I'm happy to be able to share that with you guys. I can't even tell you. That's my passion. So as we wrap this section up. This is to understand where we're coming from, why we got here. What you are, the next part for you is Danielle is coming up to talk to you about the bracelet and what, how that's all going to work for you.
Thanks. Somebody should do something about that.
Then I realized, excuse me, not used to those. I am somebody. Terry's talked about the concept, and now we want to talk about what do you do? Where do you go? How do you leave this room, and what are you going to do with it? What does it mean to you, and what can happen with it? Oh, I need the clicker, tree.
Sorry.
Okay, first thing. Your brains probably, at least some of you, okay, mine was at the beginning, but I'm already kind. Why do I need to do this? Why do I need to be involved in this? I do this every day, that's my heart. And that I'm not. We are not here to judge or question your current kindness, and frankly, we talked about this, we're assuming you're all really kind. So there's not an issue there. This is about propagating this concept, this way of being, telling it to your friends, explaining to someone how it felt, the joy you got from something, and moving on from that after you've done something, but also the people that you're giving this bracelet to, receiving that, you're spreading that kindness and not doing it quietly in a corner. You're sharing it, saying you can do this too. Bracelets equal. Pay it forward times e to the power of 5. We think this is an incredibly exponential thing, which you saw in the movie where the little boy draws and his parents were saying, oh my gosh, I'm not good at math, but that looks like it gets pretty big pretty fast. And it does. So you imagine that little boy, each of you do your own picture that little boy did in the movie in your own spheres of influence, and this is now, we are not 80. We are thousands already walking out of this room. I'm going to illustrate it with a story. My son and I were driving down for his Joslin diabetes appointment in Boston, and there was a median and a homeless man sitting to my left, so I was on the driver's side. And I have a change purse, so we're fumbling, the light's red, and I give him change. And it was very, he was much like this, but his head was down, his hood was on, and he put his hand out, took it. And that was the end of that. And I'm embarrassed to say that my son said, he's 17, Mom, give him a bracelet. So, I know, really bad, not good for the movement, I get that. So I said, excuse me, loud enough for him to hear me, and I held this up, I took it off my wrist, and his face, he looked, excuse me, someone's talking to me. So he looks up at me, and I said, all I want you to do is to do something kind for someone else. Doesn't have to be today. And I'm giving you this bracelet to put on to remember to do it, and then pass it on to someone else. I'll never forget the face in my life, ever, from a guy that did not look up from me handing him cash that he needs. And he looked at me and he said, I will. My son, 17, almost cried. And the man just looked at me and said, I will. And that was the end of that interaction. But it could have ended at the money. So I was already kind. Right? I was already being kind in doing that. But this created an entirely different interaction. And the first thing we had, which I did not have when I handed him the money, was eye-to-eye contact. When you have eye-to-eye contact with someone, you're creating a relationship. I know it's fast, I know it's on the side of a road, but it's a relationship. So I was able to connect with him different than handing him some money. I engaged him. I talked to him, I told him a story. He answered me, he said, I will. So we had this interaction that we would not have had without this bracelet. I don't know how to explain this, a little quirky and weird. It felt like we had hugged. I like hugs. I just wanted to share that E with you because it was not better than a cyberspace hug. It was right there, and his eyes said, you just hugged me, ma'am. So that was pretty cool for me. Kind of weird. If you know, you can skip that E if it's a little off. Encourage. So not only did you do something kind for someone, I encouraged him to be part of that picture that little boy drew in the movie. Encourage him to go do it also, do it for someone else, and share what he just felt and what he just received, and to share that with someone. And the other thing is empower. So I encourage him to do it, but I'm saying you can do this. I just did this. It's a little thing. I think it was about $1.72. It was not exciting with the money. But I'm empowering him by talking to him and giving him the bracelet and sharing that in that interaction and empowering him to do that. The other thing is handing him the money was kind and generous and lovely, and you can feel all great about that. But the fact remains, when someone gives someone $1.72 or $50,000, we're in different socioeconomic planes. We are. He's needy. I'm not. I'm driving my car. And there's still a little bit of a distance. And by giving the bracelet, we've leveled the playing field. I am a human being with hurts and needs and love and all those things, speaking to a human being with hurts and needs and love, connecting on a level where unbelievably we are two equal human beings that are capable of spreading kindness no matter who we are. And that couldn't have happened if I just gave him $1.72. So there's so much involved in the exchange of the bracelet and what it can, then the relationships that it can create. Okay, each person must live their life as a model for others. We know Rosa Parks did that. So it was a great quote to use. But how are you going to do this? When you leave this room, how are you going to do it? What are you going to do? How are you going to model this? How does it look in your life, in your sphere of influence, and in your business? Right now, we're going to have workshops and groups, a little game. There's a paper that you're going to share under the bowl on the table. You don't have to get it yet. It is a blank list of 10 things on a personal level and a blank list of 10 things on a business level. Things, you're going to have a discussion group with your tables. Things that you can do at home, at your kids' school, in your own personal life, your own sphere of influence, on your way to take your son to a doctor's appointment with a homeless man. All the things that you do in your personal life, we'd like written on that personal side. And then discuss in your groups. You'll have about 15 minutes to do this, so there's enough time to really get some good discussion going. Then in your groups, discuss the things you can do as a business, and I don't mean necessarily the business as a whole, but in your business sphere of influence, but also as a company, as a corporation. What are the types of things that you can do? So it's about, I don't know if you've ever played Scattergories, it's a bit like Scattergories and you're trying to get a list, and we just haven't given you any letters that you have to start with. And what we've done is we're also playing a bit of Taboo, because we don't want you to add those five ideas. We already have those. And since really what we're doing is you're paying to give us a great list of ideas, you're going to give them to us. But no, the good news, we're PIFers. We're going to share it. Everything that comes back in here that you discuss as a group that we can do as an industry and as individuals, we are going to send back to you in an email a list of ideas and how to do this and what has worked and that sort of thing. So, does everybody understand where we're going with that? Are there any questions before we move into the game? Okay, great. So these can't be on the list. You guys have 15 minutes to discuss. You need one scribe.
Okay, guys, let's go. What I'd like to do now is I'd like to have whoever thinks they had some really good ideas, and I hope that's all of you, I'd like to have some hands raised to read the best personal and the best business idea your tables came up with. So who's going to start that for us? Oh, I love it. Thank you, Jen. Stand up, please.
Commit to let at least 5 people a day in traffic.
Love it. Love that. Okay, Alex Moran's table. What do you got?
We like giving away umbrellas to people that are walking down the street.
We do too.
Nice. Oh, I mean, we like regifting gift cards as well, but they have to be activated gift cards.
Those are good. Dundee's table.
Yeah, I guess a couple that I'll samples to the Navy, and in some cases there's the opportunity to interact with other charities. So using the Pay It Forward concept and merging it with other charitable causes. Day off on an employee's birthday.
I want to know who at that table came up with that. I'm pretty sure it wasn't you.
On the personal side, and those in Toronto will appreciate this, smiling or waving at the initiator of road rage.
Thank you. Who else has got ideas they want to share? Janice, you got to... Wonderful.
Or possibly shoveling a driveway for an elderly or just any neighbor.
That's what, awesome. Sam? She did. Well, actually, obviously, that's a great idea because it came up twice, so go start shoveling if it starts again. Awesome. Anybody else want to share? Okay, so you can see we've collected some interesting stuff. I hope the discussions are good. They looked pretty lively, and that's great. This is the next part is, these are some of the things, and you can you take a quick scanner at those, but we're going to send you all this information, and we had some of those, Share Your Umbrella in the Rain, Donate Blood, even organ donorship is a huge pay it forward, right, that many people don't do or take the time to do or just sign the card. And then in business, we did that. We said something about bottled water and snacks for the courier. So there are lots of ideas. We're going to take what you have and what we have, and we're going to bring them back to you in a form that you can actually put them into action as soon as you get back to the office. This is a great one. Competitive advantage is realized when leaders intentionally manage employees and clients, not manage clients, satisfaction and morale. It is the heart of the program from a business perspective because, obviously, happy employees are better team workers. There's more respect in the office, and it carries home. There's no question. Happy people at the office are happier at home and more patient with the homework. You know, and for those of you who have the children, know that's probably one of the worst parts of the day. And it just kindness begets kindness, and it's really, really, really important that the head person in the organization starts the trickle down effect. So that's a big part of what we do. So business benefits, you can look at it here if you like, or here. These are what we think the reasons, the selfish reasons, if you want to call them that, that Pay It Forward could and should be in your business. It does engage customers, there's no question. It's something to talk about that's different. They want to know what it's all about. If you wear wear something, the bracelet is obviously a great icebreaker and starting point. Motivating employees, you can do it in all kinds of ways. A, that life is kinder in a kinder place, but also getting everybody involved in charitable activities and team runs for charity and all that kind of stuff can start working together as an inter-office team to come outside in the community. So reaching out to the community, I mean, the ways to do that are endless. C2BK is a big part of that for those of you who want to get out there in your communities, in your children's schools, in your school of your nephew, if you have teacher friends. There are a lot of ways to take it out into the community to educate our children. I mean, we really do, as a society, need to start educating our children's hearts as much as we do their minds. We don't do that in our school system. And a pay it forward philosophy in a school can change that. And we've seen it in action and we've seen it happen. C2BK, there is a school, I'll just give you the one example of many. One of the schools in Toronto is celebrating their 50th anniversary and they had a big 50th birthday party at the school. They asked me to come and speak to the kids, which was incredible for me, probably not so much for them. And they have challenged the children, and they were from JK to 8, to do 50 acts of kindness each over the year in the school. So, and that just gives me the chills to think about it because I'm thinking 800 kids by 50 acts of kindness amongst each other. If you think of where the culture of that school will be in June compared to where it started, it'll be day and night. So that's just one of many, many stories of where to take that. So promoting kindness, obviously, making a difference in the world. And, you know, as you get as old as I am, and we won't say it, what that is, and yes, my sister and I are twins, make a difference in the world, it starts to matter more, and you start thinking about that, and what am I here for? And so that's a real opportunity to do that. It creates community everywhere. I mean, it is the best talking point I think I've ever had in my life, this bracelet, and what it means, and people's opinions of how it works, why it doesn't. It's created unbelievable connections for me. And, of course, changing the world, small thing that is. But we truly do believe it will happen, and you guys are a big part of that. I would just like to mention quickly, and I wasn't going to do this, but I want to introduce everybody to my son, Alex Craig. He came here last night. Well, and I, yeah, isn't he fabulous? He's 19. He came here yesterday and helped us unload, and he stayed. Actually, we went out for dinner, and he finished doing this room and getting it all ready. And he's back here for a job interview today, actually. But he is one of the teenagers who took it to heart. He's been wearing his bracelet since the day I brought it home and has talked to kids and strangers on the street, and he really understands and gets it, and I'm very proud of that. So I just wanted to say that. Sweetie, I know you love that. The question came up today, where to get the bracelets, and that's funny, I'd forgotten about that part. The bracelets are the part of this that's to move the forward. So where do you get bracelets? There are actually quite a few ways to do it, but Debco has stock bracelets on the floor, orders of 500 or more, directly from them. So you just send in an order, they know what it is, there's no customization of that, just the bracelet with the Pay It Forward experience logo, website on the back. VP Marketing does the C2BK bracelets. So if you have schools that want to get involved, usually at this point that can still come through me because I'm trying to actually chronicle the Canadian school system, how that's working here, but that's going to get out of hand a bit eventually. But he's the one, so VP Marketing. And the PPPC also stocks bracelets, and you can buy them from them in quantities of 100. And if you want a custom order, and that's an order of 5,000 or more, that you want your own website on the back or your own Facebook page or whatever it is you want to do to engage the customers to come back to you and tell their stories, Debco will do that as well. So that's a separate thing. You need to talk to their customer service people. So you have lots of options to get them. You have two here, so we'll talk about what you're going to do with those in a second. So this is our long-term goal. How to be a pay-it-forward company. Well, hopefully when we gather all your papers, we're going to have a little more understanding of that. But just imagine a world where companies, corporations, were clamoring to get the designation of being a pay-it-forward company. That's what they were looking to be, a company that was kind in their work, in their homes, and that there was a designation of things they had to do to get there, and that's what they were striving to be. This is probably the biggest thrill for me of all of this, that there will, and I believe there will be time. The companies will come to this position. We will get this happening. We will take all your ideas. We're working on this every day. So hopefully all of you at some point will be, we call it PIF 7B, Pay It Forward for $7 billion designation, and we hope that that's going to happen sometime in the next year, get this going, and you'll all know what that's going to be, because you will all have had a lot to do with that. And just, I have a note at the bottom, just if anybody asked that, Pay It Forward, I said it's not a charity, but it is a not-for-profit organization and is a 501c3. It is my great pleasure and honor, actually, to introduce you now to the next speaker, the last speaker until I come back, Charlie Johnson. Ed's mentioned Charlie at the beginning. He did give up his entire business life and all that went with it to take this movement to the world. He's been doing that for almost 2 years. Is it 2 years? 18 months, 2 years. He is the president of the foundation. He did create the bracelet aspect of this, and he is the executive director on the board of the Pay It Forward Foundation. So please, please welcome Charlie Johnson.
Can you guys hear me in the back?
Oh, Charlie, my son's here.
Good to go?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm just going to leave it loose like this. Let's see here. Terry and Danielle have been spending far too much time with me because everything they said is literally what I would say. So I could literally pop up here and just say ditto. I got about 10 minutes, so I'm going to treat this like a TED talk. The simplicity of this movement is something I hope really sinks in. As I was sitting back there with our table, and I was watching other tables, I was listening to people talk, it became difficult to get to that 10th spot on the things we could do on a day-to-day basis of being kind. This is a very, 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 very unique time in history. Everything is digital. Everything we do is Facebook, Twitter, texting, email. Everything we do takes away that human connection. Everything. Everything. We need human connection. We need that personal touch back. We need to get back to that time where we don't need to figure out a list of 10 ways to be kinder. We've lost it, but we can get it back. We desperately need that back. 18 months ago is when I decided to take off from my business. And I lived at home. I'm going to tell you this just to give you a background. I lived at home until I was 28. For me to leave what I left was beyond insane for me because I like security. The very fact that I get up in front of, and talk in front of people scares the living hell out of me, and I'm going to do something I shouldn't do, which was walk in front of this, but I got to walk around. I just wasn't happy. I just wasn't happy. I needed to see what was going on. I needed to see what the world was all about. I didn't like what I saw. One of the options was let people in traffic. And I remember one day driving to work, someone got cut off. And it wasn't a grown adult who got cut off. And they lost their damn minds. I was sitting there on the freeway wondering what happened in that human being's life for them to just absolutely lose their mind over the simplest of actions. And it just changed everything about me. It changed everything I wanted to do. It changed everything I cared about. It changed everything I thought the world was about. And doing the traveling we've done in the past 18 months, one of the things that I have desperately wanted to know is why are we here? What do we do? Why do we do what we do? And do we care? Are we at our core good or at our core selfish? Now, that's a question I still have not figured out. I have not figured that out. The one thing else that I was looking for was something that all 7 billion people can be a part of. A lot of these kindness movements, a lot of these things that people do have some type of religious affiliation. They have some type of country behind them. They have a language behind them. They have a color of skin behind them. They have something they're fighting for. You remember Occupy Wall Street back in the days in 2007, 2008? I think it's amazing for people to stick up and do what they believe in or do what they want to do. But we need something. We need an organization to wrap around and guide that. Because now it's non-existent. No one talks about it. That movement really did not shift much in what they wanted. Because a lot of these movements, you can ask them everything they're against, everything they hate, everything they want to tear down, everything they don't like, and they'll tell you everything about that. But you look them in the eye and say, well, okay, if you get your way, what are you going to build? What are you going to create? How are you going to make things better? And what's the next step after you tear that thing down? They don't have an answer for that. I have begged, prodded, asked question after question. I am, as Einstein would say, murderously curious as to why the hell we are on this planet, as to why we have gotten this at this point in our world, why there is so much of what we don't like in this world. And we make things far too complex. We need simplicity. And the only thing that keeps my mind coming back is this movement. It's simplicity. It's the little tiny things we can do on a day-to-day basis that all 7 billion people can be a part of. No religious affiliation, no political affiliation, no color affiliation. There isn't a human being on the face of this planet that cannot be a part of this movement. There isn't a human being in this room or anyone we've spoken with across the world who can't walk out of this room after listening to us talk and say, I can't be a part of this. There are tens of millions of people in this world who want to be a part of something better. Everyone in here, I assume, has kids. Most people, you want the future of this planet to be better for the kids than it is for you, right? We all have to do something. There are tens of millions of people who want to do something but don't know what to do. This movement gives you little, simple ways to be a part of something that makes this world better immediately. And we just want to get started. We're not asking you to change your diet. We're not asking you for money. We're not asking you for anything massive. We're not asking you to make any change that you're not comfortable with. We're just asking for little tiny things. And the big thing with C2BK in schools, I am not a fan of anti-bully. I don't know about what you guys, but when I was a kid and my parents told me what not to do, that's exactly what I wanted to do. And just because there's hundreds of millions of dollars and celebrities and all this momentum behind anti-bully, they don't want to stop it in schools. But if we continue to tell kids what not to do, it's just going to progressively get worse. And if you look at the news and you look at schools, it's getting worse. We need to walk into these schools and give them something good to do, something to build off of, something to create, something to give them something to look at that person next to them and say, I made their day better. We need to shift it up. And this is different. This I've never brought this up, but can I suggest a book really quickly? It's called Uncharitable by Dan Pallotta. It talks about the nonprofit and charity world and how desperately we need to change things. This movement is not just a kindness movement. We are going to find some way to sustain this. We are going to find absolutely some way to get to billions of people. If we do not get to billions of people with this, to me it'll be a failure. We want this to get to the point where if you see that logo's not up there, if you see that logo that's all over your table, it's instantly recognized by billions of people. We need to bring a business aspect to this movement. I've watched for 2 years so many people who want to do kind things, but it wanes off, it tails off, because they don't have something to go after. They don't have an organization to talk to. They don't have someone to answer those questions. We need to bring a different aspect to nonprofits and charities. We need to bring a different business-like aspect to solving the world's largest problems. Because in business, if we have a problem, we throw resources at it, we figure it out. In the nonprofit world, we throw resources at it, and the only thing we truly care about is making sure that the costs are low. Secondly, helping the needy. It's a little backwards. We need to switch things up. Have I taken my time yet? 2 minutes. I'm hoping the simplicity of this movement makes it so that you leave here and you look at the world in a different way. Because I've been to my fair share of talks, and I've been to my fair share of these self-help gurus that just drive me crazy. And everyone gets pumped up in the room, and everyone leaves the room, and then life takes over. And the only thing, the number one thing that you're going to walk out of here is, you know, where's my next order? What supplier am I going to go see? Where am I going on the trade show floor? Is my mortgage paid? All those simple day-to-day life things. I'm hoping the simple process of this movement, of these little things you can do on a day-to-day basis, just simply shift things a tiny bit in your world. So that when you walk outside and you see that neighbor, you see that person who needs it in traffic, you see that person behind you who needs that coffee, you see that person who is just walking by you on the trade show floor or on the way to work or on the school, and you see that they're not smiling, that you simply smile at them and say hello. These little tiny things done by tens of millions of people are not little. Nothing massive is going to shift this world. It's the little things done by 7 billion people. It's those little things you can do when no one's looking. We desperately need it. Everyone in this room knows they want this world to be better. Everyone knows they can be a part of that. I'm hoping to hell that when you walk out of here, you do not forget the simplicity of this movement. And I hope that those little things you can do get done. So when you walk out of this room, will you guys pay it forward? Will you do the little tiny little things? I'm done. Thank you.
Okay. Two bracelets on the table for each of you. One's to put on, and the other one is to give. And we actually developed the one to wear, one to give program for kids, because when we started putting the bracelets into schools, we found the kids didn't want to give it up. They liked it. They wanted to be reminded. So we now talk about one to wear, one to give. You keep one on to remind yourself every day, but you try to find your recipient for the other one. It's not always comfortable, and it's not, as I say, necessary. But if you start to think, sometimes for some people it is uncomfortable to have that moment of saying, it almost sounds like, hey, aren't I great? I did something nice for you. Here's a bracelet. But it feels like that to some people. And if you reverse it back out and understand what my sister was saying about the engagement and the empowerment of giving, it's all about them is what I mean, and not about you. It's not about what you're feeling when you give the bracelet. It's about what they're feeling when they get it. And it makes a huge difference. My sister's going to hand out, and my son, thanks all, are going to hand you a paper on your way out. It's on the top of it, it's called Tell Me Your Story. Our challenge to you is that you will go out on this trade show floor or out to the bars tonight or whatever it is you do and find something nice to do for someone. And I want you to write that story down on a piece of paper we're providing and bring it to our booth before the end of the day tomorrow. The first four people who bring the story, and it has to be one that you actually do. You can't make up something you did yesterday. Okay, it's got to be new. Although that would be easy, but don't do that because that'd be cheating. The first four people who come to our booth, 406, booth 406 across from the big honkin' PPPC booth, will get a prize, a pay it forward prize, and a nice one. And then all of the names from all of you, because I'm hoping all 80 people will bring those stories to us in the next 2 days, there will be a draw, and the winner of that draw will get 100 bracelets to start their pay it forward on their own. So that's the challenge. I hope to see all those bracelets on you all day. I have to thank the partners. As you can see, your table was filled with gifts. We had some people just step up in, you know, I can't tell you what it's like being me, right, with this, because people are so unbelievably giving and love this movement. So as you can see, let's go. We start with Bic, who gave you the purple pens, which is now my favorite pen because it actually writes in purple. Chocolate Inn and Taylor and Grant gave those two die-for cookies and the candy. Debco has given the tote bag, that's that little folded cute thing. That's actually the bag for you to take all your stuff away. And they've donated some of the prizes that you'll pick up at the booth when you come with your story. Gala, beautiful balloon bouquets. Leeds, what we call the Pay It Forward Gratitude Journal, which is what I hope you use that for, to write down all the things that you are grateful for and all the ways you want to pay that forward to other people. PPPC, who gave us this opportunity, donated the bracelets that you have on your wrist today. Redwood Classics, who I don't know if you guys all know that Redwood Classics, they're made in Canada, a supplier, but they also have created a Pay It Forward line of garments. And so go see them. And they donate bracelets with those garments, so go take a look at Redwood Classics, made in Canada. And the first two people who come to our booth will get one of those. VisPac. VisPac has done a million things for us and given us a lot of literature and stuff, but for these purposes, it's the RFID shield. Did I say that right? For your credit card, and what a beautiful thing to put on your credit card, because every time you pull out your credit card, you remind to pay it forward. Love it. And St. Regis, who, you know, obviously gorgeous, gorgeous etched mugs that you're all going to take with you. And there is such a stunning bowl on the center of that table they did. And so the person who has a purple ornament on the bottom of their chair gets to take that home. So if you all want to look and see who that is at your table, somebody gets to take that. Whoever you are, yahoo! We've even provided you the packaging to take along with you. And you can take the candy, too. Okay, and y'all can figure out how you can bribe the person to get it. I can't, there's not much I can do about that. And obviously we have a... Yes, I am. Well, you are, I'm not. You win. We want to say an incredible thank you to our sponsor of this session, Brand Alliance. You could probably tell, they not only supplied many things to help us be here, they supplied our outfits for this session, and they didn't even know that I have an absolute collection of high-top running shoes, so like I was so excited. Brand Alliance has taken it on corporately, and as I say, I really would like you, those of you who are not wearing the shirt, to track down those people who are. To talk about what they're doing. They've got some really interesting things coming. They've done some charitable things on their website already. But they also are a company who understands the concept that in order to feed the hungry, you need to be fed. And Pete Kamak particularly, I just want to say thank you, because he understood that for us as a company, in order to do what we're doing to get this to you and pay it forward. So they sponsored a lot of what we're doing to get us here for this session. And we are incredibly grateful. It was a totally uncalled for generosity. It was just overwhelming to us, and I have to say. And please seek them out and talk to each other and look for other bracelets on the floor, on the show floor. Connect with each other, eye contact, embrace her anyway. She likes the hugging. I'm not so much. Embrace each other, engage each other, talk, find a recipient, and again, buy a coffee. Help somebody who's dropped that big bag of stuff on the floor. I mean, there's so many ways you're going to see out there. Just do it. We truly believe that a simple act of kindness can change a person's life. And we believe that if you choose to embrace that into your life and in your business, please don't be surprised when the life you change is your own. Thank you so much for coming here, and have an amazing show.